Hello students, let's continue the chapter Building with Bricks. Jamal and Kalu, the masons of Jagati school. Can you remember there were three masons, Jamal, Kalu and PR. Now these two are discussing. Jamal and Kalu, the masons of Jagati school, said that their grandfathers used many different kinds of bricks. Some of these are shown in this photo. Here given from this first question. Which of these bricks have curved edges? Which of these bricks have curved edges? First of all, what is edge and what is curved edge? Let's see. Here, a brick, a cuboid is given. Already about brick or cuboid, we learned how many faces does this have? How many faces does a brick have? Does a cuboid have? Six faces, is it or not? It is top, bottom, front, back, left, right. There are six faces. Now we are going to learn about edge. See, the top face and this front face meet at a part. This meeting part, the straight line is called edge. Likewise, you can find, see, this face and this face meet at this part. So this is called edge. So this brick, this cuboid has edges. All the edges are straight edge only. All the edges are straight edge. Could you see all are straight line or not? So all are straight edges. There are totally 12 edges. How many edges? 12 edges. See, top 4, top here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Likewise down also. 1, 2, 3, 4. So top 4 and down also 4. So 4 plus 4, 8. Then the standing edges. See, 4 edges are standing. So top 4 and down 4. So 4 plus 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So totally there are 12 edges in a brick. How many edges? 12 edges, but all are straight edge. But here the question, what about curved edge? Let's see curved edge. See, this is a cylinder and cylinder has two types of face. Here this face is plain face, flat face. But this face here, this is one, this one, no, that cylinder, I mean water bottle, the holding part, no, where you are holding, that is curved edge, sorry, curved face. So this curved face, this face and this plain face meet at a part. See, this is called curved edges. Is it looking like curve or not? So we say this is curved edge. So how many curved edge does this cylinder have? Two curved edges. So what, which part is called curved edge? This face and this face meet at a part and this part is called curved edge. Likewise, they are asking from these bricks, which of these bricks have curved edge? Here you see everywhere, but this first and second have curved edge. This part, here also curved edge, and the second brick also have curved edges. So the answer, first and second from top left are having curved edges. Then the second question, how many faces do you see the longest brick? Here among these, which is the longest brick? Yeah, this one is the longest brick. And how many faces can you see? Could you see? Only one face we can see clearly. So only one face of the longest brick can be seen in the given figure. Third question, is there any brick which has more than six faces? Is there any brick which has more than 6 faces. In last class, I showed you real brick and explained about the faces, totally 6 faces only. So, there is no brick. No, there is no bricks with more than 6 faces in the given figure. Let's see the next. Find out the size of a brick. Have you seen bricks of different sizes? Here generally we use these types of bricks to construct building a home. So now we are going to measure the brick. So the first one, how long is it? Long. Long means length of the brick. So the length of the brick is 10 inches. This is general. Generally we are taking a brick. Okay, general brick. And what is the length of the brick? That is long means length. See, this part is called length. Length of the brick, 10 inches. How many inches? 10 inches. Then, width, wide. How wide is it? Wide means width. Breadth. So, the breadth of the brick is 5 inches, this part. Breadth of the brick is 5 inches. Then, the height of the brick, 3 inches. The height of the brick, 3 inches. So, the length of the brick, long of the brick, 10 inches. The width or wide or breadth of the brick, 5 inches. Then the height of the brick, high of the brick, 3 inches. Then, what about inches? Let's see about inch. 1 inch. Inches means you could have seen with a tailor. I mean, a tailor has a measuring tape. That tape we say inch tape. So, 1 inch is 2.54 centimeters. That 1 inch is how much centimeter? 2.54 centimeter. Okay, now we are going to convert the length, the breadth and height of the brick into centimeter. Everything here we are seeing in inches. Let's see in centimeter. The first, we are going to convert the long length of the brick. If we know 1 inch, we are going to find 10 inches. If you know the value of 1, to find more, we have to multiply. Listen, because multiplication gives you more. Of course, addition also gives you more. But here, why do we multiply? Because we have in our hand the value of 1. We have the value of 1. If you know the value of 1, to find more, we have to multiply. So, 1 inch is 2.54 centimeter. So, to find the value of 10 inches, we are multiplying here. 10 multiplied by 2.54 centimeter equal to 25.4 centimeter. What is this 2.54? Did you see like this number in earlier classes? Did you hear about this? I think no. This is called decimals. What is this called? Decimals. So how to multiply a number with decimals? Let's see here. We are going to multiply a number 10 by 2.54 centimeter. This is called a decimal number. How it is decimal means between the two digits there is a point. This point is called a decimal. What is this point called? Decimals. Decimal point. So after, that is right hand side of the decimal point, there are two digits. After the decimal point, right hand side of the decimal point, there are two digits. So we are telling this value has two decimal parts. How many decimal parts does it have? Two decimal parts, because right hand side of the decimal point there are two digits. So we say there are two decimal parts. Okay, now we are going to see how to multiply this value. to multiply a number by decimal or a decimal by number, take away the point first. Remove the point first. If you take away this point, it becomes what? 254. So 254 multiply by 10. We can change the order of the number in multiplication. Is it or not, children? 3 into 4, 12. That is 3 fours are 12. 4 threes are also 12. So we can change the order. Why do we change the order? We are taking the greater number first, then the smaller number. Now we are going to multiply the number. Now we are multiplying a number by 10 or 100,000, like that comes mean. We can multiply shortly, short method. Take out the zero, because here the zero is end of the number, not middle. So it is the end of the number. So take out the zero. In the answer column, you write it as last digit. In answer column, first you write it as last digit. Then here, if you take out the zero, here it remains one only. So 1 into 254, any number multiplied by 1, you get 254 only. So here you are writing left of zero, you are writing 254. So the answer is becoming 2540. After getting the answer, after finding the product, we have to make decimals, because we are multiplying with decimals. How many decimal parts are here? 2 decimal parts. So here also we are going to make 2 decimal parts by moving from right end of the number, from right side of the number. So how many decimal parts are here? 2 decimals. So we are going to make 2 decimal parts here. From right side we are moving 1, 2, then we have to keep point here. So now the answer is becoming 25.40 centimeter. So the zero can be taken or can be left also. So the answer is becoming 25.4 centimeter or 25.40 centimeter also. So next, this length of the brick, 10 inches, we converted into centimeter. Now let's convert the 5 inch, the breadth of the brick. So how do we do? We know the value of 1 to find the value of, if you know the value of 1 to find more, we multiply. So here also we are multiplying with decimal, because 5 into 2.54. 1 inch 2.54 to find 5 inches we are multiplying. Again it is decimal multiplication, so take away the point, it is becoming 254, then multiply by 5. You know very well to multiply a number by one digit. So when we multiply, we are getting the answer 1270. Then we have to make decimal, is it or not? Because we are multiplying with decimal. So here how many decimals? 2 decimal part. So right hand side of the point, 2 digits. So 2 decimal part we are going to make here. From the right end of the number only we should move. So 1, 2, then we are keeping point here. So it is becoming 12.70 centimeter or 12.7 centimeter. Then let's convert the height of the brick, 3 inches into centimeter. So if you know the value of 1 inch, to find 3 inches, we are multiplying 3 into 2.54 centimeter. Again it is multiplication of decimals. So take away the point, it is becoming 254 into 3. Then we are multiplying with 3. So when you multiply, you are getting the answer 762. After multiplying, we have to make decimals. So here 2 decimals, we are going to make 2 decimals here by moving from right end of the number, 1, 2, then we are keeping point here. So it is becoming 7.62 centimeter. See children, here 2 decimals and here also we have to make 2 decimals. Suppose if you move from left end, After two digit, if you keep the point here, your answer is becoming 76.2. That is, you will have one decimal part only. So, to keep the point, we have to move from right end of the number only. So, now we converted length. The length of the brick, 10 inches or 25.4 centimeter. Breadth of the brick, 5 inches or 12.7 centimeter. Then height of the brick, 3 inches or 7.62 centimeter.